so let's start with this. So I want you now to assess this patient's airway. I've given you the data there, and then I want you to make a judgment call. So in this first example, I think they did a really good job. We already went through the fact that this was a pretty brilliant, standard patient aside from the beard. So the way I think about this patient, this is just a patient without a beard with a beard. You wouldn't treat this any differently. But the number of times in the viva that I'll give this to a senior registrar and they'll want to do a fiber optic intubation is quite often. And that's because they get in the headspace of wondering what is right to, what is right and what should be done. But really, this is just difficult bag mask, but everything else will be fine. Bag mask difficult due to beard, LMA, no issues expected, endotracheal intubation, no issues expected. I'd just give a fast acting relaxant so I don't have to bag mask too long or have to rely on that. And exactly right. So, if someone's willing to shave their beard, fantastic. But if there's no other indicators of badness, I think there's not many of us who insist on shaving the beard. If this patient was an impossible looking airway or difficult from many points of bag mask, LMA and ETT access, I would ask them to shave their beard. That's a really good point. Okay, this one. I want you guys to make a decision. Say, take 30 seconds to a minute. 40-year-old, male, not female, large incisional hernia repair. And this patient's assessment looks like this. Again, I want you now to make a judgment call. Bag mask, difficult, easy. LMA, ETT, difficult, easy.
So based on all the numbers, it looks okay. I can see that it's for an incisional hernia repair. But I guess if I had to do, I think if he was having something like a scope where he had to support his own airway, just all that soft tissue might cause some problems. Mm-hmm. So for an LMA, we hope that insertion would be fairly easy. If he wasn't paralyzed, maybe he looks like a larger guy, so just ventilating might be a bit more difficult.
Yes.
And for an ETT, with those numbers, it doesn't look like it should have too much trouble.
Absolutely. I completely agree. So because of the size of the patient, bag mask and LMA could just be inherently difficult because you need very high pressures to be able to ventilate, increase the risk of everything. So for me, this is just a straight intubation, but with a fast acting relaxant. And I really need good positioning. And you'll often see these patients ramped up with this Oxford pillow or other pillows and using a videoscope just in case. Just note that all it takes is to add some complexity to make this difficult. So imagine that this patient, you have to anesthetize them in a foreign environment with a junior assistant, or the patient had sick lungs or heart. Suddenly, what was not the worst airway is suddenly far more difficult. And you might need to even just give the cardiovascular management to someone completely different so you can focus on the airway. Just something to think about. The airway is never an airway isolated because it can often involve other complexities. 55-year-old male, shoulder reconstruction. You do your 5-second airway exam. Here are your findings.
So I'd say he's got a bit of a mustache, but I think the bag mask ventilation should be fine. Have a Gazelle on standby just in case, but I think it'll be fine. I think LMA should be okay. And I'd say ETT is going to be difficult due to the malampati of 4. And I'd want a video laryngoscope.
Fantastic. That's exactly the system I want you to talk through. Bag mask okay. LMA should be okay. ETT may be difficult. So malampati 4 means overcrowding of structures. As long as I can get past this with a Gadelle LMA or videoscope, the airway shouldn't be too difficult. Again, in experienced hands. So I wouldn't expect a junior reg to be doing this at all on their own, let alone even a senior reg without some assistance. 21-year-old male, ruptured spleen post-MBA. So malampati's a bit unknown because the collar's still on. Mouth opening's 4. Neck extension is not there because of the C collar. Thyromental distance 6.5 and jaw protrusion A.
Bag mask ventilation should hopefully be okay, although it might be difficult with the C-spine precautions. ETT will be difficult with the lack of neck extension due to C-spine precautions and the unknown malampati score. And LMA would possibly be easy, but may also be difficult.
Yeah, and especially because it's probably a trauma patient needing a rapid sequence induction, the ability of the bag mask and LMA is maybe limited and not ideal. But mechanically, it is fine. So no issues, but the aspiration risk is a problem. Maybe there's blood in the airway. They talk about a laryngoscopy grade decreasing by 1 when you've got C-spine immobilization or manual inline stabilization. That's great. as you can see, I'm getting you to talk through each of these, outlining the difficulty, because the way you manage stuff is through the bag mask LME or ETT format, and it means far more than if you were to say it's a difficult airway or not difficult without specifying that. How do you assess this patient? 60-year-old female, anterior resection for bowel cancer, and here are the details.
I think that bagging this lady should probably be okay. It might be a bit hard to get a seal if she's got sort of floppy skin on her face. Mm-hmm. LMA should probably be all right. She can open her mouth enough and she's a Marlin Patty too. And then ETT, I think this would be a difficult sort of intubation. She's got, you know, a grade B jaw and a short thoromental distance. So you'd want someone experienced and have some options like video or maybe awake fiber or something.
Perfect. So bag mask K, LMA K, and every now and again, I'll see this kind of patient every few months, and they've just got a very particular look with the very, you know, narrow, the thoromental distance and jaw protrusion in this will be the ones that mean that I just, it's like there's a bit of an anterior larynx, which means I can't, the angle's even more hyperacute, and that's what makes this difficult to visualize for intubation. Exactly what you said, videoscope shouldn't be too difficult. And if I can bag mask and LMA this patient, which I invariably can every single time I've done this, and I can always do an a sleep fiber optic as well if I thought an awake fiber optic was not necessary. Again, these are kind of advanced decisions, but I would just want you to know that this is the way we would think about this. This patient's airway, 64-year-old male for a wrist GAMP, Marlin Patty 1, mouth opening 5, but the neck is fixed because he's got ankylosing spondylitis. So you can't really assess the thoromental distance, and jaw protrusion is A. So what do you guys think of this?
Yeah, so obviously you're sort of 90 degrees out from where you'd hope you would be, mm-hmm. In terms of his neck fixation with no extension. So, and even like if you're trying to bag valve mask him, there might be lots of soft tissue issues and high pressures. You might not be able to get past LMA, similar issues, just because you'd be hard to get around that bend, and then particularly out of the ETT tube. So I'd imagine you want some kind of video assistance, if not fiber optic or something like that.
Absolutely. So this is an example where it's such a gross abnormality. It's so ridiculously bad that you just don't even know. All bets are off. Everything could be difficult and I wouldn't even risk it. This is awake fiber optic, or just do it under local, whatever it is. So in summary, this is how I target my assessment to make sure it relates to my management and naturally leads to a plan. It's so clinically relevant that I just encourage you all to think of it this way. It's, you know, just shows a lot of clinical acumen to talk about it like this. And that's really the way that anaesthesia has kind of progressed over the last decade or so, to target this style of talking.